All right, so here's the main entryway, guys. We're looking at tombstones and mold. It's dropping down. I got shit falling on me already.
You look up. You can see into the other room.
The other room there, it's like floor's buckling in. You can't really see it.
You look in the basement. Like, I stood in there for a second. You could see the floor in the basement.
Yeah, like if you get in, the floor is actually coming through from there. Come to the left here, you can actually see where squatters or some sort of tweaker was like living.
Hey, real estate investors, welcome to another episode of the Investment Properties for Sale Show here on HoltonWise TV. As always, I am your host, James Wise. Now, this is the show. If you're looking for cash flow, guys, this is the show where we bring you investment properties from around the world. We handle top to bottom property management, investment services, any and everything you could imagine in the Cleveland market. And through other markets in the United States, we provide you guys some of the best cash flowing investment properties from other turnkey providers that could handle the top to bottom needs of any real estate investor. Before we get into the property, though, I want to start today's show off with an interesting question, because this particular property, it's in a really rough neighborhood, a very poor neighborhood, a very impoverished neighborhood, an incredibly blighted neighborhood. Now, just recently, I launched another video. I titled the video, Touring America's Most Dangerous Ghettos for Cheap Real Estate Deals, and then the property was 1285 East 115th. Now, that particular property was very, very similar to the property I'm going to show you today. And, you know, that video is pretty popular. We just released that. It's only been out for a few days, and it's already got over 10,000 views. And what had happened is we had one particular person comment on YouTube that they thought it was offensive. They thought we were implying offensive things. Essentially, what this particular person was doing, she was, you know, barking up the tree that we were implying racism in the titling of our video, in some of the terminology that me and my other team members used in that video. So what I did is I put this on Facebook. I put it on my personal Facebook page to, you know, see what everybody else felt. Because I don't think, I personally do not think it is racist to call an impoverished area the ghetto. In my opinion, that's just kind of, you know, what they're known as. I don't think of a particular race or a particular group of people when I think of the ghetto. What I picture is, when I hear the word ghetto, I picture blighted neighborhoods. I picture boarded up windows. I picture completely destroyed and impoverished and just wretched and horrendous buildings like we show you here on HoltonWiseTV TV very often. And in my Facebook thread, you know, a lot of people were answering questions on that. A lot of people were going back and forth. We ended up having over 175 comments on that. Granted, a lot of them were from some maniac named Steve Stacks. I think that guy's got a screw loose in his head. He don't make any damn sense when he talks. He might be just a troll. But other than that, a lot of people were providing some pretty solid input into the topic. So I wanted to take it out here to you guys, all you folks out there watching HoltonWise TV. What are your thoughts? Is it racist to call an impoverished neighborhood ghetto? Also, in addition, can you call an impoverished area the hood? I want to hear your thoughts. I want to hear all of that. Pump those in the comments below. Let's get a solid discussion going. As for the property at hand today, for the rest of you who come here for those cash flow investments, you are ready to earn some money, so let's get right into it. 13931 Kinsman Road, Cleveland, Ohio. This is a four-unit building. It's mixed use, right? We have two units that are residential, two beds, one bath, and the other two units are retail, you know, vacant storefronts. The entire building is 100% vacant. It is coming to you at a price of $9,900. Now, if you haven't picked up what I've been trying to say throughout the entire show, this is an incredibly blighted and impoverished neighborhood. I don't necessarily think I want to use the term ghetto right now, because that is in debate on whether or not that is appropriate for this show. It's not like HoltonWise TV is afraid of offending folks, because we do that pretty often, but I want to hear you guys' thoughts on whether or not the term ghetto has any racial connotation to it, because offensive, running the line, talking about complete transparency in this business. That's what we're all about. And in an effort to bring transparency, we do ruffle some feathers. But I do not stand for racism or anything of that sort. So I want to really understand what the general public thinks about those terms. Now, as for the building itself, it is completely freaking destroyed.
The structure is pretty unstable here. We were able to get in through a back door. This is like a storeroom. Gas meters, we got electrical on the wall. There's holes in the external structure, and as you can see with the roof here, I mean, the ceiling's coming in. There's nothing stable. Smells of mold, dampness, moisture. You come to the left here, you can actually see where squatters or some sort of tweaker was like living.
But what is nice about the particular building is the location. You're right there in a main commercial district. You know, these types of buildings, when I sell these types of buildings, because we sell a lot of the properties out here on HoltonWise TV to out-of-state investors, and they get those top-to-bottom solutions from either us here in the Cleveland market or from our network of other turnkey vendors in the other markets you're used to, like Kansas City, Dayton, Ohio, Memphis, Tennessee, etc. But we also sell a lot of blighted properties here in Cleveland because we are, of course, the number one seller of investment properties in the Cleveland market. And all these Cleveland properties, they typically work the best for local, seasoned, sophisticated landlords. This is not something that a brand new investor should ever try to buy. Don't think, oh man, it's a four-unit building for only $9,900. I can't possibly lose money. You absolutely could lose money. And in addition to that, it's incredibly hard to hire a property manager, a sophisticated property manager, to do work like this on your behalf. So the types of people that actually make money in these really impoverished neighborhoods are the local folks, the folks who are cutthroat landlords, who know how to deal with an incredibly difficult tenant base and who could also do repairs and major renovations much cheaper than the average person.
That's like part of the commercial space through there. Same thing with the roof. I mean, it's coming in for sure. It almost looks like there was a structure fire here at one point. You can tell right through there.
Yeah, dude, look at that.
So there's nothing about this that's secure or safe.
Rentec Direct provides you with an easy-to-use yet robust platform for managing your properties, complete with its built-in reporting and accounting system that can be customized to fit your business. You can manage work orders and even accept them online from your tenants. You can also share work order details with tenants or owners if you wish. With Rentec Direct, you will also fill your vacancies faster than ever with the built-in marketing tools. Just enter the details of your property and Rentec will automatically provide you with a professional online website as well as syndicate them to popular websites such as Zillow, Trulia, and Apartments.com to get your listing maximum exposure so it's rented fast.
I mean, the whole fucking floor came down on one part of this, so it is what it is, but can't really get around too much, so there you go. I mean, if we go into the upstairs, there's almost no doubt in my mind we're going to come through that ceiling. So we're probably not going to do that. The other entryway, we were able to sort of pry, but I mean, the floor's coming in through there too. So the only place that's secure enough is the wood area here, or the concrete area rather. So yeah, there you go. Welcome to EC, homies.
To be able to pay a company, a third-party licensed contractor to do a renovation like this, I don't know if you could feasibly get it done for a price that makes sense. With this particular building being in the middle of this commercial district right here, you do see some other new construction right around the area. I don't even know if going in and trying to renovate it, since it's so jacked up, it's so far gone, even makes sense. This particular building, the play here might be to just buy it and tear it down to develop into something new later, possibly get some grants. I don't for 100% know off the top of my head if this particular plot falls in an opportunity zone, but if I had to guess, I would assume it does. So I think the opportunity could be there for some folks who have a very solid grasp on construction, new development, or at the very least, renovation and the property management industry. So cutthroat landlords, new developers, folks that know what they're doing are the only folks that should target an investment like this. For the rest of you out there, what you want to do is just watch the shows on properties like this in these incredibly impoverished neighborhoods and just gain some education and advice. And I don't want you guys jumping into these really tough neighborhoods chasing that paper cash flow, because if you are not prepared for an investment like this, it will chew you up and spit you out. But for the rest of you that this investment does make sense and you know who you are, need you to send your offers to sales@HoltonWise.com. Of course, we're only willing to accept as-is cash offers, no contingencies whatsoever. If you have members on your team that also want to see the building, like if you need your construction foreman to get in there and things of that nature, we want to provide transparency. So if you have your own buyer's agent, we have a lockbox on this property that you can go ahead and tour this whenever you want, bring anybody you want with you, and then present us that as is offer, because we're not doing this contingent on anything. It is sold as is, where is. That's all I've got for you today. As always, I'm James Wise with Holton Wise, and this is Real Estate Investing Made Easy.
USREEB is a full-service, turnkey provider offering investors the opportunity to purchase single-family and multifamily investment properties in Cincinnati, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, and Kansas City, Missouri. The purchase process is seamless, from reserving a property to obtaining financing, inspections, and insurance referrals. USREEB has a dedicated team in place to manage the process from start to finish. In addition, USREEB is also directly integrated with its own private placement fund for accredited investors. The fund seeks to raise $10 million to capitalize on the repositioning of distressed single-family and multifamily real estate. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on our latest content, including video tours and analysis of investment properties that are available for sale, real estate investment education, and our most interesting encounters with tenants from hell. Holton Wise, real estate investing made easy.